Remember, this video is hashtag sponsored by hashtag Niantic.
For those of you headed to any international flight,
ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Chicago. It is time. It is the biggest event of the year. It is Pokemon Go Fest happening. Oh man, my lens. So some housekeeping regarding this weekend and regarding some meetups happening this weekend. There's a meetup today happening probably when I upload this. What time is it right now? Oh, it's happening in 5 minutes. I forgot about that. I probably didn't make that or I'm late, sorry. But speaking of meetups, I am doing, along with some other influencers, daily meetups at the GoFest event for 2 hours each day of the event. So I'm gonna announce the details on that in a second. I do wanna talk about Pokemon Go announced Shiny Horsea. Shiny Horsea is gonna be live, happening not only just at Pokemon Go Fest, but all around the world. So where's the tweet for that? In celebration of Pokemon Go Fest 2019, the water-type Pokemon Horsea will begin appearing more frequently during globally on June 13th, which is tomorrow at 9 a.m. PST. If you're lucky, you might even encounter a shiny Horsea. So that is live for the entire world, and obviously that's going to be all over Go Fest. Who knows? We might see some more shinies here at Pokemon Go Fest. Gonna have to find out. But that's the new shiny coming to the game to celebrate GoFest for everybody, so that's cool. And then regarding the meetups, on the map for GoFest, it'll be listed as autograph sessions, along with a Pokestop in-game to direct where to go. Tickets for the meetups are gonna be handed out from 11 a.m. to noon every day until they run out. And if you do wanna meet more than one content creator, you will have to get a ticket for each creator and wait in each line during the signing sessions. And with this is just kind of meet and greet, quick signing, selfies, no Silph Road handshakes. So regarding the meet and greet, it just kind of has to be quick because we have a lot of people to meet in not a lot of time, but it is 2 hours. So the meetup will happen from 1 to 3 p.m. every single day of the event. And that's how that ship's being ran. So that's what's going on with the meetups, and that's what's going on with GoFest. Speaking of, actually, you can see, I don't know if you can see in the camera, but I see a Pokestop like right there, and there's like a sign, this is a park. So that's exciting. So yeah, big stuff happening, awesome weekend. Stay tuned for all the great content. And Jake, let's get it, Chicago. Oh, and also enjoy today's video where we explore around Hawaii and have an awesome adventure and catch a brand new shiny that we have not caught before. So enjoy. Check this out, wild Pupitar spawn. What? At the stop. Jake actually texted me and called this out. They are getting poke right now, a little pokeball, while I'm finishing up this video to get up to you guys on the channel. This video being the, which one was this? The Shiny Onyx video, which was sick. So, Shiny Onyx number one, actually, that is, out of two. So that's awesome. Freaking Pupitar spawn. That's dummy rare. Ridiculously rare. I am so down for that spawn. Also, leap. Speaking of leap, actually, let's talk about this right now. I caught a shiny leap the other day. Wait, there's an Anorith right here. Okay, I caught a shiny leap. I didn't have my camera. I recorded the screen, but I'll show the screen recording right now of me obviously finding and catching the shiny leap. And you can tell, by the way, that of my ball movement on screen, I was a little bit excited about that one. So that was so sick. I actually met two awesome fans on the beach. They gave me hot sauce and a t-shirt. So thank you very much for fans, viewers, friends, thank you guys for coming over and stopping and apparently blessing me with the shiny look, because immediately as I walked away from that, walking back to the hotel, because we had a dinner that night at Side Street Inn, which was delicious in Waikiki, would absolutely give that a try if you're in Waikiki, I freaking clicked on this thing, on this little leap, this little guy, and it was shiny, which was super sick. So now we have got two different shinies. We have an Onyx, we got two shiny Onyx actually, and then now we've got this guy here, I'll show him right here, the shiny leap, which is super dope. I'm debating if I wanna, I probably won't evolve this, I'll just keep it as a leap until we catch another one, and then we can evolve to the shiny Credilly. But for now though, I'll keep a leap, because a leap is a fun little shiny, and I like keeping them unevolved when I get them. So that is super cool, I'm so excited about that. And then if we can just finish off with, you know, a shiny Anorith, we won this event. So I thought that was pretty exciting. Little Pupitar, shiny little leap, gang. Oh yes. Nice. This is literally my favorite thing ever. Like ever. Like there's sushi, number one. Poke is number two. Hey baby. Ooh, darling. Hey baby. I love your love, love. We have 7Ks, some 7-kilometer eggs hatching. I wasn't able to spin stops, and I had to open a bunch of gifts, so I ended up with 7Ks. I don't want these 7Ks. I don't want to hatch them, specifically because 2Ks right now are on fire as a part of this Adventure Week event, which is ending somewhat soon here, so I probably should be taking advantage of that. Oof, it's been, you know, it's been some relaxing days here in Hawaii, but I'm definitely slacking on the go. I also need to walk and do this. I also have a whole box of poke. I'm so excited to eat. Are the eggs done? Oh, they definitely glitched. Nothing exciting. Okay. Also, oops, that was our 7-day streak. We have Shuckle here. Okay, we're gonna go to the beach. Before we do that, though, I will claim the stamp to the day, which is gonna be a little bit of a Anorith. We don't have this shiny. We've got Lileep. We've got, I mean, an Onyx and a Steelix. That was a great throw. I'm gonna wait till Community Day to catch something, unless it's shiny, because of the Stardust. And Community Day is today, but that won't be the video right now. This, you'll see it later. But okay, cool. There's that. I'm gonna eat poke and go to the beach. Actually, at the beach here, I'm gonna cave and drop this star piece, and I'm gonna be dropping, do I have a star piece? Caving, dropping a star piece, because there is actually a Larvitar spawn here. I'm just gonna catch that, that's rare. We haven't found many Larvitars as a part of this event, even though their spawn rate has been heightened. I don't see many of them. So, all right, star piece down, we'll get the 7-day streak, and I'm gonna drop a magnet lure here too, because we have a stop right on top of the beach. There is no reason to not lure that. We don't have much more time in this event, and I don't have the shiny Anorith. That was good. I've used an Larvitar. Okay, why not drop a little lure? I think actually for the Community Day today, I'm gonna use the magnet lures across, you'll probably have already seen that video, but I'm thinking about that. Okay, we're gonna lure up, we're gonna see what happens here. And I kinda wanna do that Soul Rock raid, not gonna lie. See if Jake is down for that. Oh my gosh, all right, hello. First spawn, Lara. I know it's part of the event. I know its spawn rates are heightened significantly, but it does not get old seeing this spawn in the wild, just knowing how rare it's been over the years. I'm mind blown. Let's get it, another Laron down. I'm gonna tell Jake that's here. He's gonna have to catch that. That's a big trade. Oh, cool beans, Leap. Let's see if we can get that Soul Rock raid in. Oh, this is funny. We have a Slackoth spawn right here. He's a couple hours early, although apparently according to everyone on Twitter, Slackoth Community Day was a bit of a bust. The game was kind of broken during that. Can I catch a shiny Slackoth? I know I can't, but like, it's just funny that spawned. Hello, also Roselia. Oh, hello. All right, Soul Rock raid. Obviously we are using the shiny Groudon against Soul Rock, sprinkling in some shiny luck. It's gonna work one of these days. These are Jake's glasses, thank you. But yeah, we're here in Kona. Dude, Kona's been awesome. I like Waikiki a lot. I've obviously been there quite a bit. Ooh, I'm not doing the damage I wanna be. Waikiki is a really fun place because it's like big city vibes, but it's like Hawaii, right? So it's like big city vibes on the beach. It's like PG Miami, it's fun. But Kona so far, I mean, I've only been to Waikiki and Kona. Kona's my favorite place I've ever been in Hawaii. This place is so sick. It's like, I mean, super calm vibes. There's some big city stuff. Jake's getting attacked by a bee. That's probably gonna come my way. It's been great. I really love Kona. It is a little bit slow here for Pokemon Go, obviously. And we'll see how Community Day goes today, and that video will already be on the channel. So curious about that, but it's been really, really nice. Obviously I took a couple days off of uploading. It's been really, really nice to just kind of like stand back a little bit, not work so much, kind of in the middle of all this hectic stuff, because obviously with like the mental health startup, that's just a lot of time and effort going into that. The new YouTube channel I've been trying to plan as diligently as possible, a lot of work and time going into that. Been trying to pump videos into the main channel too at the same time. It's a lot happening at once. I've been feeling overwhelmed is like an understatement, very overwhelmed lately. Just like a lot of big goals I'm trying to accomplish in a little bit of time. So it's been really stressful. So it's been nice to kind of like come here and not so much escape all of the stress, because I still have been working, I still have been doing emails and scheduling calls and working out deals and stuff like that. So things, obviously, and still making videos because we're here now. Things are still happening, but I've been kind of doing it at a slower pace and just relaxing more. I've been using a lot of this time for like helping myself, shiny check, prioritize. Oh, did you get the shiny? No. It's been more kind of like going over priorities so that once I go back to Los Angeles after this trip, obviously I go to Los Angeles for a day, I go to E3 for a day, and then we head to Chicago for GoFest. So pretty busy. But once I get back to LA after GoFest, just kind of like trying to plan out where my priorities lie and where a lot of my attention will be allocated, because that's kind of important. Your time is your most valuable asset. So I've been working on how to most efficiently use that. All right, Soul Rock down. I'm gonna go hang out on the beach. We're gonna chill. That's the gym badge. And I'm gonna eat poke, and that lure's mine. I'm gonna use that lure. You're gonna have a great day. So, yeah.
Okay. This is actually the last adventure of the day, and it's a pretty cool last stop. With 10 kilometer eggs happening right now, also there's a bit... Shinx, okay, that's a great 10K hatch. Obviously not shiny, but it's okay, because we haven't hatched a Shinx. We haven't hatched something out of a 10K that I'm not annoyed with in so long. I'm so happy we hatched that. Wow, that was great. If we only do more of that. 5K has some stuff that I need, including some shiny stuff. I still haven't had the egg glitch that a lot of people are having that looks hilarious that I would love to tweet. Well, here's this area here. We're at Rainbow Falls right now. We're gonna be doing a little bit of a helicopter tour today. So we're definitely ending with a bang. And actually, I can leave something here. There's only one thing to drop. It's an L. There you go, Rainbow Falls. You're welcome. Actually, there's a shiny slacking in there too. We're hanging out here for a little bit. We got about an hour to just chill and see if we can get any shinies or anything. And then we're going up in a helicopter, which is sick. So awesome way to end the trip here. This is pretty much it for me. We're gonna do this. We have maybe like one more adventure today. I need to get some research. I'm gonna go spin those stops. Maybe one more thing we're doing today, driving up along the coast, and then we will be going to Black Sand Beach, I think, in a little bit. After this adventure, and then I head out tomorrow morning. So this is like the grand finale to the trip. Let's go spin the stops and see if we can get a research task and complete that here. Sick, Anerith Plant. All right, that's cool. All right, at these stops, we're gonna give these ones a spin. We got Rainbow Falls Cafe. Nossum, I just woke up from a nap. Bag is full, keep forgetting about that. And check. This should still be Adventure Week research. We need to fill up on that because the event ends soon. Evolve a Leap or Anerith, that's fitting. What is this one? This is gonna give us hatch two eggs. we just did that, dang it. Oh, and here are the other eggs that hatched that, broke because the egg glitch is still happening because Pokemon Go won't fix that because the game is broken. Sick, let me catch and keep this little leap and we're gonna evolve this at the top of the waterfall and get that stamp and get a shiny, hopefully, fingers crossed. Actually, I'm not gonna lie, I might be banned. For some reason, I might have a shadow ban on me. Everything I've tried to catch has ran on the first ball. So Golden Raspberry Ultra Ball here on this Anerith. If this thing runs, I don't know. Oh, maybe not. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna stop talking. All right. Welcome to the set of Avatar 2. And here on set, we actually have a spawn, Anerith spawn. I'm not banned, which is great, which means we can actually evolve the Anerith we caught earlier and get our stamp. And I think this would be a cool spot to do it, yeah? We'll get Sid from Ice Age on the set of Avatar 2. This literally looks like I'm walking through Avatar. This is sick. These trees are A, gorgeous, B, impressive, and C, something. I just want to climb it, Like, tell me you don't, look at that tree. Tell me you don't want to climb to the top of that. Like 7, 8-year-old me would go crazy in here. I'm not gonna do it because my mom would yell at me. But no, this is super tight, man. This is a great spot. Rainbow Falls, if you guys are looking for somewhere cool in the Big Island area. All right, claim reward. This will give us our stamp, potentially a shiny. This is one of the, not really last, but one of the last Adventure Week researches we're gonna do, definitely in this video. And it's gonna, we already have this shiny. We actually have two of this shiny, so I'm not even tripping too hard about that, but cool. That's kind of what I want. Kind of what I wanted to do here: catch a little bit of Pokemon, pop a little evolve, and look at a tree that I wish I could climb. So, again, now we're kind of going to do a little bit of a helicopter tour, which will be sick. So, awesome, adventurous, green, luscious last day here in Hawaii. Oh, let's get on the freaking helicopter! Oh. Thank you. Well, this is different. Welcome to Black Sand Beach here in Hawaii. As you can see, the sand is, like the name suggests, crazy enough, it's black.
It's volcanic. It's a volcanic beach. This is so cool.
And as you can see, we have like lava, volcanic lava rock along here. And it just...
This is so sick. This used to be lava one day. I'm walking where Blaziken used to walk, where Heatran was born.
Actually, this is literally, we're standing on a dead Heatran.
That's a bad joke.
But that is super sick, dude. That is tight. And then as you can see, the entire beach is just, it's black. It's black sand beach. This is really cool.
Not only is this beach just super cool and black, there's also apparently turtles around here. I can't find any. I wanted to take a selfie and upload it to Twitter with the caption, "Who's that Pokemon?" I can't find any turtles. Well, speaking of Pokemon, at least we've got a ton of Pokemon here. We got a brand new, the Coffee Shack. We'll stop there, which is great. And we've got a bunch of shiny checks.
Jerk.
Kabuto. Okay, so that's that. Nothing shiny, but you know, plenty of possibilities, opportunities here at the Black Sand Beach. And actually, we have a Graveler, which is good. Whatchamacallit. This is called Stardust. Also, I am thinking of Pokemon to take a picture of, and like an AR plus shot up here because this is just sick. And shiny Charizard is it, man. Like if shiny Rayquaza was in the game, I mean, this would be perfect because again, it's like. Yeah, Black Sand Beach. This is like, and actually, I'm looking at the sand too. It's not like normal sand. It's just like little, they're just tiny lava rocks. That's so sick. Also, we cannot leave the island with any of this sand. It's insanely bad luck. So, know that if you ever come to Black Sand Beach, it's super cool. Don't take anything home, because then you curse yourself. Essentially, we don't want to do that. Although there's some really cool rocks here, like this. All right, Texas art here, 2800 CP from Dallas. Shiny Charizard. I'm saying that's the background. I'm saying that's money. Okay, let's pop him out there. All right, nice. Yeah, shiny Charizard on the beach. That's a beautiful scene. One more time, Charizard. One more. And a little low angle. Great. Look at that, dude. Charizard on Black Sand Beach. This is sick. This is very perfectly fitting. I'm gonna tweet a picture of this of me with Charizard on Black Sand Beach because. Again, I couldn't think of a better Pokemon to do this with, but beautiful. Charizard, thanks for coming out. I appreciate the shot. Sweet. And yeah, this is Black Sand Beach. This is like the last destination that we're doing here in Hawaii. So we had an awesome helicopter tour today with the fam, and then now we have an awesome little adventure here at the beach. So that's cool. And if I find any turtles, I will show you. We can't touch them though. Do not touch the turtles. That's another thing to remember. Cool, man. Black Sand Beach. Aloha. And mahalo, and thank you for the air shots. And is there anything else to do here when it comes to spawns? Not really. Dope. I gotta find a bathroom, get a raid in 22 minutes that we're not gonna be here for, and I'm gonna go play in the sand and upload some pictures to social media. Check out Instagram and Twitter. That's where it's all gonna be. Hope you guys enjoy this Hawaii adventure. It won't end here, but we're close to ending. But yeah, sick. So what we saw from above in the helicopter of like, just kind of the lava flows going over the island, this is one of them. This all is dried up lava. I think, this looks like it would be, or maybe it's just overturned gravel that they use for construction. This looks like
it goes all the way up there.
There's no way this is, look, see, like this is where the lava would flow down here and it kind of stopped alongside, didn't kill all that grass. That is cool to see, that tree just popping out of nowhere. But to my knowledge, this is a lava path, and then the road right there too. Float over the road, built it right over this. I don't know if this is from the most recent eruption. I actually don't know where we are on the island technically, but I know for a fact that like this is cool. It's like a barren freaking wasteland. Yeah, look, that's gotta be molten right there coming down here, like right in that area, right? Like that too. It looks lava-y. Maybe I'm wrong, but to me this is really cool. Okay, I'm gonna leave. I don't know if I'm supposed to be out here. This is kind of scary. This is more lava flow, lava flow, lava flow. This is older, as you could tell from the story behind the scenery. If you want to pause and read that, you can't read that from here. Older, but still lava flow. Okay, now we're leaving the lava and stingrays?
I'm excited to see this from here again.
Nice. Wow.